Welcome back to Extraordinary Women TV with Shannon Skinner. I'm now joined by Marsh Engel, who is the inspired visionary, who is an inspired visionary, feminine success coach, and transformational journalist. She has coached hundreds of entrepreneurs, authors, and those in the transformational arts. Marsh founded Amazing Women's Day and authored the acclaimed book, Amazing Women's What's Your Story? She's based in Los Angeles. I'm so grateful to have her here. Now, of course, later in the segment, before we take a break, I'll have my regular Good to Know Minute when I ask my guests for their top tip on creating a successful life. And I know Marsh has a fantastic tip, and you're not going to want to miss this one. So, Marsh Engel, hello.
Oh, Shannon Skinner, I am so happy to be here with you. I mean, here we are in Toronto. And we met just 2 years ago, and before you had your show, and before Amazing Women's Day had really been launched in the way that it is today. And now we're in Toronto celebrating together.
Yes, and I of course had the great fortune of attending Amazing Women's Day in Los Angeles, which was the last time I saw you, back in January. And I'm so thrilled to have you here today.
Thank you. Very happy. I flew in on a red eye yesterday, so I was talking this morning on the way over in the car that yesterday, I think by flying a red eye, you have this rich day yesterday. I felt like I lived 2 or 3 days all in that 24-hour period that I've been here. And Toronto is such a beautiful, beautiful city. So happy to be here.
And of course, you happen to catch some pretty good weather now.
Yes,
it's getting warmer.
Yes.
Thank God.
Gorgeous.
Now, what is an inspired visionary, feminine success coach, and transformational journalist?
Well, you know, I believe we're all inspired visionaries one way or the other, because we're creating a vision for our life each and every moment. And to tap into that inspiration and live that greatest self that's wanting to be expressed all the time is really what that inspiration's all about. So when we can align that inspiration with the vision that we're holding for our life and the action that we're taking, that becomes an inspired visionary. So I think it's finding that trust and taking action upon that trust so that we can bring forth new innovation and new creativity, and that's what we're all about here today as women.
No, I love this part of who you are, transformational journalist. I've never seen a journalist expressed in that way. So that's really interesting. And what do you mean by that?
Well, it's actually a great story. You know, originally I was not a journalist or even a writer or an author. And it was very challenging for me to even accept any of those titles, because what I came from back in 99, I was running a marketing agency for television and film studios. And my mom passed away suddenly, completely unexpectedly, on January 19th of 99. And then I had a health diagnosis that was not a very pleasant one. And then I had my father passed, all within 18 months. And it was such I call it a wave of awakening. It was such a transformational period for me that I honestly, Shannon, did not know where to look other than to women like yourself, to women outside in the world that were living their inspiration. How do I open up to connect more deeply to myself, what's longing to be expressed through me, and how can I start to align my own actions so that my life reflects that fulfillment? How can I do that? And so I started a journey. I called it a search for the amazing woman. And I'd wake up every morning, I'd see myself exploring the world, interviewing and talking to women and people that I met, and learning from you so that I could find a way to ignite that passion within myself, to ignite a deeper connection with purpose, and what I call today a sense of mission, to really where I'm out in the world in alignment with what wants to come through me as my own unique expression of creativity. So I started to write about the women that I met, and I called it then transformational journalism, because it really is. It's a story that when we tell ourselves, or transform the way we tell the story to ourselves, or we share it with others, we have this great opportunity of transforming a life, whether it be our own or whether it be the lives of others.
Do you remember that moment during that whole time of transition for you, that you said, this is exactly what I want to do, I'm on my path?
You know, I think that when we first start to unfold our new life, which is really what it was for me, I went from behind the camera as a marketer of other products and services and programs for television and film to in front of the camera, which was me becoming an author. It really is a transformational period and a transition period that we have to allow ourselves, because I think one of the biggest mistakes we make when we're looking to change our life is we think it has to all happen at once. We have to feel like we're comfortable in being mean that new definition. We have to feel like we can really own it in that moment. And I believe that it's a period of allowing. It's a period of understanding. It's a deepening of a connection with really what we wish to bring forth in the world. And if we can allow ourselves that patience and understanding of ourselves and what's unfolding in our life and begin to just step into it slowly. So I didn't really have to walk out and say, this is me. Although I will tell you a great story is that when I first decided to become an author, I identified myself as an author, and even though I had no idea what book I was going to be writing. And I started to consider myself an author. I put it on my resume, on my business card. I'd go to my parties and I'd say, you know, Marsh, what are you doing these days? And I'd say, you know, I'm out there, I'm an author, I'm writing. They'd say, well, what kind of books are you doing? I have no idea. I have no idea, but I know that I'll be writing books. And so I think that holding that vision while you're allowing yourself the patience of it becoming a reality or being realized, and know that it may not happen just overnight. It could happen overnight, but it also may happen over a period of time. I think that's the most important tip that we can have when it comes to allowing our life to transform.
Now, do you think that you would be where you are today had you not lost your mom and your father and of course had your own health issue? I mean, if this had not happened, do you think that you would have stepped into such transformation yourself?
Well, it is an excellent, excellent question, because I do believe that our destiny is unfolding constantly. I also know that sometimes there's catalysts for change. There's these opportunities that really urge us forward to make a real difference in our life. And I don't know that we necessarily have to have those kinds of catastrophes or that type of drama or that type of intense periods of change. However, I do know that when we do have those, they can be transformed into something that will really be make a huge difference in our life if we choose to see those as that. If we choose to see that there's something happening here, there's a deepening, there's a greater expression of me wishing to come forth in the world, and how can I bring that forth through this experience, which is ultimately what happened when my mom died and then my health and then my father. It was this 18-month period that said, Marsh, there's a whole lot more of you that wishes to be expressed, and if you will allow yourself to open up and you will allow yourself to see life differently and experience life differently. It was really allowing me to be redefined by a new definition. But, you know, letting go of those old definitions are so challenging at times.
Was it scary?
Oh, it's a sort of, it's still scary. You know, it's still scary. I mean, I would just say that anytime we're going through change, anytime we're letting go and we're allowing something new to come in, because it's not proven to us, and we're living on that edge of transformation constantly, it can feel a little bit fearful or a little bit scary. But I'll also say that during those times of living on that edge and living during those periods of transformation, which is really constant, it's the most powerful woman you can ever be, is to really tap into those moments and let go and allow that change to happen.
Now, why is it that you're the most powerful when you're doing that?
Well, I think it's a great question too, because it's when we define ourselves by old standards, okay? If I'm defining myself by a year ago or 10 years ago or 15 years ago or 5 minutes ago, if I'm defining myself by that moment, I've actually limited myself in seeing the new opportunities that are unfolding in this new moment. Does that make sense to you?
Oh, yeah,
so it's
absolutely.
We're constantly staying in that creative flow where we're allowing ourselves to open up and receive and see new ways and innovate change. And it's a different way of approaching, because I don't know about you, Shannon, but I get really comfortable thinking I know exactly who I am and exactly where I'm going, when in reality, the most powerful place I can be is to have a vision of where I'd like to be and a vision of what I'm creating, and then allow the universe or allow the life to come up and match for me those opportunities so that I can say yes to those as they come to me. And they may come in a different outfit, or they may come in a different way than I might have perceived that they'd be coming to me. Does it make sense?
Yeah, and now in terms of, you know, authentic feminine success, of course, is what you talk about and write about quite
yes.
a bit now.
Yes, I do. I sure do. And the reason for that is that I built my first success in business based on a very structured model of success. And we could call it a masculine model, or we could just call it a model that seemed to be natural to me because it was the only one that I knew. But I left on the side much of my creativity. I left on the side a lot of my community and bringing together teams of people together to create. I also left on the side something very important that was my intuitive callings. So when I stepped away from that life and that business that I had created from that type of model, I committed to create a success from a different point of view, one that would be very feminine related and be very creative. And that would be lots of community, lots of collaboration, lots of connection, lots of ways that I could trust my intuition and follow and not have to have such a set way that I was doing it, but rather allow it to flow and unfold. And any of you that work next to me with the programs that we lead for Amazing Woman's Day and with the coaching programs that I offer know that we're creating constantly, so what you come to and what you experience is going to be very much your own experience rather than what I think you should have. It's going to be an atmosphere and an opportunity for you to experience life in a new way because you're going to see yourself in a brand new way.
Now, Amazing Women's Day, let's talk about that. Now, what is it and how did you create it or what inspired you to start Amazing Women's Day?
Well, what inspired me to start it was, of course, my own journey, a search for the amazing woman. And I was actually in Teotihuacan, Mexico, studying with Don Miguel Ruiz that wrote The Four Agreements. And
right,
I was there in the pyramids and hiking and studying and searching. Honestly, it was my own deep desire to be of service. And I think, don't you think we all have that calling that says there's something more for us to share in the world? And that's really where
I believe deep down each one of us does. That's right, yeah.
And that's really where I was. I was actually longing to connect more deeply and saying, I don't know all the answers. I don't know, but allow me to discover something new, a new way of bringing forth change and community and transformation and making a real lasting contribution in the world. How can I do that? And the answer came to me, create a day on which all women honor themselves. Create a day on which all women honor themselves. And I thought, that sounds like such a huge statement. It's like, how would I possibly do that? And of course, the minute that I asked the question, the answer came to me. It said, use the resources that you know that are naturally your own, that you've been trained for. Use those resources like creating books and programs and live events and bringing community together. Those things that you long for are what Amazing Women's Day would be. So I set out on my mission and I created Amazing Women's Day, the first one in 2001, which is 10 years ago, believe it or not.
Congratulations.
Thank
you.
It's our 10th anniversary. Amazing to me to imagine that, because it honestly feels like yesterday to me that we just started the vision. And that's how quick it expanded so rapidly. And we were in 10 cities our first year. We were in 50 cities our second year. And now, of course, we're in multiple countries and cities throughout the United States.
Now, of course, you're in Toronto this upcoming Saturday, April.
Very excited, and you're part of it as one of our media partners. So very honored
and also excited.
Very, very grateful for the work that you've done with us. But Amazing Women's Day is happening April 16th. It's at the beautiful, brand new, and elegant, I will say, Ritz-Carlton. You know, I love to have beauty around us when we're celebrating Amazing Women's Day. That's exactly what we're doing here in Toronto, too, with the Ritz-Carlton. We're bringing together a community of women that are transformational leaders, they're entrepreneurs, they're creative, they're experts, they're focused on well-being, they're coaches, they're mentors, and they're really inspirers. And the day will be filled with opportunities to connect with your tribe, with your community, that will reflect back to you new possibilities. I love to see the collaborations that come forth through that day. As far as the experience, what can you expect or anticipate to experience? It's really up to the individual woman. What we do is we create this amazing opportunity for you to meet and get to know women that are like minds, that are making a real contribution in the world. And from there, the collaborations that come forth and the celebration that begins to happen is truly amazing. So I invite everyone to come out, anyone that's called to connect with a room filled with transformational entrepreneurs and women who are making a real difference.
And for more information, of course, you can visit the website at www.amazingwomensday.com. Amazing Women's Day, April 16th, Ritz-Carlton Hotel. I haven't seen it yet, so I'm really very excited to see the hotel. So we're going to talk a bit more with Marsh Engel after the break, and I'm so grateful to have you here.
Thank you.
We'll take a break and we'll come back.
Gloria Steinem once said that the real definition of a movement is to coming together in a common vision to support one another. I never forgot those words. Hi, I'm Marsh Engel, and it's no secret, amazing women, there's a movement that's happening among us. It's a calling for us to step into our ultimate purpose, to live our greatest passions, and to share our talents. And that's exactly what's happening in Amazing Woman's Day. Just like our sisters before us, we're trailblazing. We're innovating new business, we're coming together to create our own communities, and we're supporting one another in living our ultimate calling. Amazing Woman's Day brings together the most dynamic transformational teachers, inspired leaders, and entrepreneurial coaches with one thing in mind: put into action a creative clarity so powerful there's nothing that can keep us from doing, being, giving, sharing, and creating whatever we envision in life. The fact is, our creative potential is much greater than we know. But to find our highest success in our relationships, in our career, in our business, and in our life, we must fully engage our creative nature and say yes to our ultimate calling. This is not about working harder. Those days of struggle are over. This is about discovering ways to share our resources, deepen our connection, and contribute our talents. Amazing Woman's Day blends transformation, education, connection, networking, and celebration, including a step-by-step process to deepen your creative connection and embody its power in every aspect of your life. This is a proven program for creating conscious change. You will explore what may be blocking you or holding you back from living your greatest prosperity, as well as learn tools for vision building and tapping into your deeper intuition. Thousands of women have already experienced this extraordinary program. In fact, since 2001, the pioneering work of Amazing Woman's Day has touched the lives of over 100,000 worldwide. I invite you to participate and take part, and don't miss this one-of-a-kind, extraordinary day of celebration. Envision the possibilities.
Welcome back to the show. I'm Shannon Skinner, and I'm joined by Marsh Engel, who's the founder of Amazing Woman's Day, and she's also the author of Amazing Woman, What's Your Story? She's from Los Angeles, and I'm so grateful to have her here in the studio today. Now, I have a good to know minute. Of course, that's my regular segment, and I ask my guests for their top tip on creating a successful life. Marsh, I know you've got a great tip.
I do have a great tip. Each moment you can choose to redefine. So rather than choosing to define yourself by yesterday's standards, let go of those and open up to receive a new definition of yourself and take that inspired action as the amazing woman that you are.
Love it. Now, your book, tell me about your book.
Oh, I love this book. It's Amazing Woman, What's Your Story? And can we show the cover?
Yeah. Oh, it's on.
It's on.
Screen.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah.
I love the book, and I love the book for a lot of reasons. First, it has a step-by-step process that allows you to dig deep into your life and unleash hidden powers within your life that you may not even know are there, and transform the way you choose to tell your story each and every moment. Because here's what we know: if you transform the way you speak about your life and transform the way you speak about your experiences, it will allow you to attract in new experiences that are of a greater vision for you. So each and every moment, we have this opportunity to transform our life, and there's a step-by-step process in Amazing Woman, What's Your Story? That teaches you that. But I also love the book for another reason, and that is that we have 15 women's stories in it that will take you not only through your own process of transforming your life, but show you how they transformed their lives as well. So it's a study guide or a workbook type of program and type of a really self-contained book that allows you to be very experiential with your process of reading it. And then you'll learn from amazing women that have transformed their lives.
What inspired you to put this kind of a book together?
Well, you know, I was on a journey, a search for the amazing woman, and I'd interviewed hundreds and hundreds of women about the way they'd transformed their lives and the way they'd ignited that inspiration, that passion, and a real sense of fulfillment and purpose in their own life. So I wanted to go back and what would that step-by-step process be? I'd interviewed all of these incredible, incredible, amazing women, but I wanted to be able to teach a step-by-step process so that each of us, whether we're living the life that we absolutely love today or we're looking to ignite that passion in our life, how could we embrace that even more? So I did. I took it apart. I took a life story apart and I said, okay, here's your first step. Here's your second step. Here's your third step. And by the time you get to the sixth step, you've truly transformed the way you see your world.
Where can people get a copy, Marsh, of your book?
Right now we're in pre-release, and you would go to marshingle.com.
Right.
You can buy the book right there on my website. And then, of course, I'll be back in Toronto very soon with a book signing and a big book release. And then another one's you can come to Amazing Woman's Day on April 16th that we'll have here coming up in Toronto as well.
Now, you know, I know that you talk quite a bit about collaboration. And, mm-hmm. you know, women obviously came together and collaborated on this book by sharing
yes.
their stories. I mean, why is collaboration mm-hmm. so important to you? And does that actually replace being competitive?
Well, I think that what a great question that is. I think collaboration is our new model of success. I think it's really bringing us to closer unity. It's bringing us to closer appreciation of one another. And it's bringing us closer and deeper into our own appreciation of ourselves and the gifts and talents that we have to share. Because when it comes to collaboration, the pure essence of collaboration is bringing the very best you into the room or into a relationship with others. So all of the work that I do, whether it be the books and the published products that I have, or whether it be the live events and Amazing Women's Days, are really much based in a collaboration business model, and that means each of us bring our very best self to that community, and then we create together and to the benefit of all. I think one of my favorite quotes is a Gloria Steinem quote that talks about the real definition of a movement is a coming together in one common vision to create that together, really. So a movement or collaboration or community is really about bringing your best self and sharing it with others.
Now, you know, one of your authors has been on the show, Christine Cirka, mm-hmm. And we're going to be speaking to a few others along the road. So, it's a great book. I highly recommend getting a copy of Amazing Woman, What's Your Story? If you're interested in transforming your life, this is a must read. What's next for you, Marsh?
Oh my goodness, next for me, I am doing Amazing Women's Days, of course, all over the United States and in several countries this year in 2011. I'm also working on a documentary series about the movement, because we've been around for 10 years and a lot of transformation has happened during those 10 years, not only within my own life, but also in the movement of women. I love the different phases of the women's movement and our own transformation. I believe we're in the fourth wave of the women's movement right now, and so I'd like to be able to bring forth more of that inspiration that's happening through our movement. And also, I think just living a more inspired life each and every moment and opening up to new creativity.
Love it. Mm-hmm. Now, of course, I must mention that we had another author on the show too, Donna DeLuca, who works closely with you. So
yes.
I don't want to leave her out. I want to mention her name. So, yes, and it was lovely having them on, talking about their stories. So I'm so grateful that you wrote this book. Well, Marsh Engel, we're almost out of time. It just has really gone by so quickly. Is there anything in the last few minutes that you would like to share with my audience that we haven't yet covered? Is there anything that comes to mind?
I think that the most important thing that we can remember is that each and every one of us has an incredible depth of talent and contribution to make. And many times, especially we as women, we can get caught of looking outside of ourselves to define ourselves by somebody else's standards or the way somebody else is doing it. I'd love to encourage each and every one of us to dive deep into that creative calling that's speaking to us individually, and in our own unique way, find the courage and the confidence to bring that forth, to share it with others. Because when you bring your best self to the table, it allows me to be inspired to do the same. I think it's the most important thing we can remember right now as women.
How inspiring. Marsh Engel, founder of Amazing Women's Day and author of Amazing Woman, What's Your Story from Los Angeles, all the way here in our studio today. Thank you so much.